Where'd Parker go?
I'll have Parker here. Where's Parker?
We keep on misplacing him. All right. All right. Okay, good afternoon, everyone. I wanted to just give a couple of updates that we have, and then we'll have some more detailed updates about the investigation. We have received several media inquiries to attend our National Night Out event. To make it easier for you to join us, we have arranged for an RTA bus to transport interested media to the multiple neighborhood sites in tonight's program. The bus will be at the convention center at 4:15 and depart around 4:30. I ask if you're going to National Night Out to use this because I don't want our neighborhoods to have a ton of cars moving in and out. We're trying to just be as succinct as possible. I'll be on National Night Out. Do you feel? Are you going? Yeah. So we're all going, and we'll be on a bus as well. So that's our offer to you. All right. Next, I'm gonna turn it over to Chief Beal to provide an update on the investigation.
Thank you, Mayor. I'm joined this afternoon with Todd Wickerham, the special agent in charge for the Cincinnati FBI office. We'll provide a brief but important update on the progress investigation of the mass shooting that occurred in the city of Dayton on August 4th. While we do not have true clarity of motive of the assailant, based upon evidence obtained, we do have a more developed picture of the evolving mindset of the assailant. The materials reviewed thus far reveal that the individual had a history of obsession with violent ideations to include mass shootings and had expressed a desire to commit a mass shooting. Subsequent material has revealed an orientation toward violent ideologies, which elevate this case to one of federal interest. Thus, the FBI will be taking the central role in certain aspects of this case, while the Dayton Police Department continues to focus on the homicide investigation. So I now ask Agent Wickerham to provide more information about this shift in investigative focus. However, I will clarify that the information provided will be very limited and not likely to be expanded upon what is already being shared. Agent.
So thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Chief. My name is Todd Wickerham. I'm the special agent in charge for the FBI Cincinnati field office. So the Dayton Police and the FBI have a long history of working together side by side in this community, including very, very important joint terrorism task force assignments that Dayton police officers have, as well as our Safe Streets task force. So working together is nothing new for us. An FBI agent showed up in the early morning hours in the Oregon district after this horrific mass attack. So our investigation with Dayton police is ongoing. We have not made any final investigative conclusions into the motive of the shooter or if he was assisted by any other people in this attack. However, we have uncovered evidence throughout the course of our investigation that the shooter was exploring violent ideologies. And based upon this evidence, we're initiating an FBI investigation side by side with the Dayton Police homicide investigation to make sure we get to the bottom and we explore everything and we try to understand the best we can why this horrific attack happened. So as we continue to conduct this investigation, we are striving to do three things. What, if any ideology, influenced the attacker to conduct this attack? Who, if anyone, helped him or had any advance knowledge of his intentions to conduct this attack? And why he committed this specific act of violence? One piece of evidence does not necessarily constitute a motive, hence the need for a thorough, methodical investigation. The case is ongoing, so we cannot provide any detailed information into our investigative activities at this time. It's absolutely critical that we do this investigation the right way. This community and our country deserves an answer as to why this happened. So we ask anybody with additional information regarding this investigation to provide that information to the FBI tip line. It's a tip line that's available 24/7 for somebody to give information. That tip line is 1-800-CALL-FBI. If you call there and ask to give information about the Dayton shooting, somebody will take that information and provide it both to the Dayton Police Department and to the FBI. There's another outlet in which people can provide any type of digital evidence that they may have collected, whether on that night or any social media evidence that they may feel is relevant to why this attack happened. And that can be provided at www.fbi.gov/Dayton shooting. And I also want to thank all the organizations in this community that have stepped up to help the grieving process and the healing process begin here in Dayton. I'll take a couple questions.
Agent, can you explain the violent ideology? What violent ideology is it that you're interested in?
So I'm not going to get into specifics as to what we found because we're so early in this investigation. There is so much more material to go through and evidence to obtain in this investigation. But we have found very specific violent ideologies that the shooter, we know, followed and was interested in. So that has given us enough information to open up a FBI investigation to make sure we have every single tool, every investigative capability to figure out why this happened and to try to make sure it doesn't happen again.
To be clear, there's a predicate for a federal investigation. That would be something having to do with either politics, religion, race, that sort of thing, right?
So anybody that wants to do violence, that is part of what has to be shown to investigate a federal investigation of this type. And so, yeah, so we have found very specific. One thing I'll point out, that we have not found any indication that it's a racial motivation. That is not we have not found that anything that indicates that it's a racial motivation at this time. I'm not, you know, again, we have a lot to go through. So, different violent ideologies will cause an investigation to be initiated, and we have found evidence of a violent ideology.
Did
but
you
I'm not going to.
I'm not going to get
into the specifics.
Did you discover this off his computer?
We did not discover it off his computer. We're still going through lots of digital evidence, but I'm not going to tell you exactly where we found this because we still have a lot more to go through. We do not have that information at this time. We don't know.
Can you define what a violent ideology? General terms, what do you mean by violent? Is it a pre-existing ideology that exists that he subscribes to, or what does it mean?
So what we saw in this is this individual, the shooter, the attacker in this case, very specifically seeking out information that promotes violence.
How far back in his past are you going? Reports of the hit list in high school?
We are going back as far as we need to find, try to find out why he did this, and also if anybody else knew about this or was involved with this.
Was there anything on radar prior to planning this event, or that he was planning to do a different type of event, or how premeditated was this event?
We don't know it at this time.
Do you have any knowledge of him having any mental health issues?
I don't have that information at this time. I'm not going to get any more specifics about what we do or what we do not know.
Did the events in El Paso affect the timeline of this at all?
We have not seen any evidence that the events in El Paso influenced him at this point. Again, we have lots of evidence to go through.
Did he have any
prior to this incident?
Final question.
No, we have no evidence that the shooter was on the FBI's radar prior to this event. So,
thank you. Thank you, Special Agent. Next, I'm going to invite Assistant Chief Matt Carper to the podium to discuss the President of the United States' visit tomorrow.
Thank you, Mayor. I know there's been a lot of interest in a potential visit from the President into the Miami Valley area tomorrow. We don't have the specifics yet. As soon as we can get more additional information as it unfolds, we'll release what we're able to release to the public. I know any closures or inconveniences, interruptions would be minimal, so we do understand that. So we'll share more information as it becomes available and as we're able to. That's all I'm able to offer right now.
Will the family be meeting with the President privately? Do you know that?
I'm sorry?
Will the families of the victims be meeting with the President privately?
I'll be able to give you more information as the details are confirmed.
What about protests tomorrow?
Thank you.
Any word of any protests?
I'm not aware of any organized protests tomorrow.
Can you talk about manpower? Is there going to be extra police on the scene at the rouse? What's that going to look like?
With any presidential visit or motorcade going back decades, that is the case.
Sir, at the White House debate, Kellyanne Conway suggested that the Secret Service had communicated to the president that both Dayton and El Paso are safe and ready for the president's visit. Do you agree with that characterization, that assessment? Is Dayton ready at this moment?
We are always ready for any kind of dignitary protection assignment. Like I said, going back decades, we've provided those, and sometimes multiple occasions per year. So, yes.
Given the circumstance that happened here?
That is correct. We are ready.
Can I ask Thank one you. More question of the agent? Just one more. You said that he wasn't influenced by events in El Paso, correct?
I didn't say that. No, I said we don't have not developed any evidence at this point that says that he's influenced by El Paso.
Have any evidence developed that he was influenced by other events? We've had several recently.
We still have a lot of evidence to go through, so I'm not going to say anything else about that.
I think we've discussed everything we're going to discuss about the investigation. So are there any other questions?
I wonder about the chief's homicide investigation.
Yeah.
As you continue to look into that gun and the ammunition, have you found any evidence that there was any violation of current gun laws by the shooter?
No, we have not.
Could you speak to the podium?
Yeah, they want to get that on. They're
That'll be
digital.
Pretty easy. No, we have not. So.
Any new information leading up to why they may have split up, the brother and sister?
I don't know that that's clear. I mean, we don't have any specific information to really understand that at this time. We just know what happened.
What is your take on the governor's proposal that he laid out today, 17-point plan?
You know, actually, I've been a little too busy to read the governor's proposal. So until I have a chance to read it and evaluate it, I really can't comment.
Sarah, can you reiterate what you said more about the visit tomorrow from the president coming in and what people should do? And
You were all there, so I don't need to, I don't want to keep on going, but you know, I don't know what you're really asking, frankly, actually.
You're welcoming the mayor in the
official capacity. Oh, yeah, I will welcome him in the official capacity as mayor, since he is in the office of the president.
Chief, the search warrant of the house, did they find any of the guns, or what kind of evidence was recovered from
there? We're not going to get any of the evidence that was seized in that search warrant. I mean, that's all part of the investigation, and we haven't a chance to even evaluate some of it yet at this point. So,
any update on the person who was driving in the car with them, the brother and sister?
So we're done talking about the investigation, so I think we're done with questions today. We appreciate, and I'll see some of you at National Night Out. Thank you.
Let me know if that comes through. Yeah. The tip.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I haven't gotten in touch with that person yet, but I will when I dedicate some attention to it.
Yeah, no. See you guys.
Violent ideologies, and they have a better idea now of his mindset.
Yeah, I don't know what they want us to do after this.